because I made these.
Dude, the squealing hawk would be good looking for Child Conroy.
Oh my god!
Damn.
Just get wrecked!
Yeah. Oh fuck.
I mean, I like the guy, I think he's funny, but he seriously is ugly as fuck.
Ural?
Damn! Guy's crew is ugly, dude.
Ural, if you look up Gourmet Sentai, I'll type it in the chat. Nock and I did that, and I think I uploaded it.
Yeah, you did upload it. That's one of your playlists.
And the other thing we did was the Super Mario RPG thing with Goron 50. I think if you look up Goron, you should find it. And I think I have my part of it on a playlist somewhere. So.
Yeah. I remember a video you did a while back. It was called Quaddy versus Games, and it was Quaddy versus Games.
I think it was
Majora's Mask.
Maybe.
Wow, you literally beat the shit out of a Zelda game. I'm amazed.
He leaves him in the kitchen in the hallway.
And when you were doing the Majora's Mask thing, it was just a compilation of, like, cool stuff you did in the playthrough, and one of them was... The ending of that video was you beating the shit out of Majora just with the bunny hood and the gray fairy sword.
Was it that?
And I watched...
I don't know if I did that. That might
you
have been
did
Kyle.
That... No. I'm not talking about the end of your Let's Play. This was like back in like 2009. This video came out.
Yeah.
Long, long time ago.
A long time ago.
He came as some surprise. He
spoke
into his
what the
hell
are you doing?
Died alone.
You're off
Cody,
you
guys.
You're both really off me.
That's gay.
No, because his fucking beat was throwing mine off, and I'm like, oh god, I don't know what I'm doing anymore.
Ooh, real knife, about time.
First things first, you don't have a beat. Second thing, sadly, you aren't allowed to sing either anymore. Jesus fucking Christ.
I mean, as soon as I sing a line of a song, it suddenly becomes karaoke hour in a quaddy stream.
Yeah, no, but like, when I first watched that video back
next
in like
thing,
earlier,
you know,
like,
he's gonna
like, shut up!
Jesus.
So.
Boy, it's gonna be just as fun.
So I. What the hell was I talking about? Oh, right. So yeah, when I watched that video back in like 08 or 09 or whenever the hell it came out, I watched you beat Majora with like the Gray Fairy sword, and I was like, Jesus fucking Christ, how? How?
It's me.
Why?
$10 says Quad quits
Why
the
would
game
you ever
because
do that?
Of this. Why would I quit the game? Oh, I think I know why you're saying I would quit the game.
Because you must have died alone a long, long time ago.
Yes.
Because we're face
but
to face.
But nobody came.
We never lost control. Your face to face. The man who sold the world.
Oh no, not me.
Damn
it. Fucked up! Seems like gardening tools. Where's the knives?
Downtown. Whipping fast, walking fast, and up.
Whipping my asshole clean, flushing it down the toilet.
But the paper's brown.
So I continue.
Did Flowey kill the king? Flowey.
My asshole.
And now I'm wiping.
No chocolate. There's no chocolate.
And some water splashed in my ass, and I don't know how the beat goes to the songs. I haven't heard it since 04. Well, that's actually a lie. I saw Terry Crews on Lip Sync Battles do that song. Like, he's sitting there, and he's like in like this white shirt, and you see him sitting at this piano. And you all know who Terry Crews is, right? He's like that big muscular black guy from the Old Spice commercials.
Yeah.
He's also
big
the president of Idiocracy.
Muscular old guy.
I said black guy.
The...
Black guy. Not old
black
guy.
Black guy. Could someone please, like, I don't know.
Old people cannot be black. It's impossible.
Hold on a moment. I'm gonna look up a picture of Terry Crews and I'm sending it to a fucking chat.
Oh my god.
What's the fuck's name?
That is a buff man.
He's the guy who's in the fucking Old Spice commercials for like forever and ever and ever. And he still is, actually. He just made a new Old Spice commercial like about a month ago. And that one literally made me laugh my ass off. He's like, I'll always be the freshest one around with Old Spice. Wait a minute. Why is there bubbles coming out of my mouth? Oh no! And you just see he's in a fish tank. I don't know.
And then it zooms out and it has the handsome, seductive guy, and he's going, oh yeah.
He's like, oh yeah, I'm the new Old Spice. And you just hear Terry Crews in the background just carrying on with the, oh no! Yeah, but like, that big, like, he's like this muscular black guy who's like, he was also in the Expendables. He's the black guys in the Expendables.
Wow. The multiple?
Wow.
The black
they just
guy
had one guy playing all the black
it
guys.
It was the one black guy in the Expendables. Wow.
The one, he was the one black guy who didn't get killed in the Expendables.
You know, I don't see race.
All
I
the
just
rest
assume
of the...
everybody's white.
So... All the rest of the brown people in the Expendables die. It's just
wow.
a known fact.
Wow.
No, at that point, it's like a known fact that if you're in a Stallone action movie, if you're brown, you're dying.
Did you just find your clan cowl again, or what's going on here?
This shit's getting real.
Jesus H. Christ.
Yeah, there you go, cleric.
How liberating. Oh my god. Yeah, at least they're better to sit around and watch it happen. Yeah, people watching the stream. Whoa.
Whoa.
What?
I'm dying in a vat in the garage.
Oh my god, Flowey knows I'm streaming, guys. He's calling us out.
What about you're streaming?
Flowey is just getting really fucking meta.
He's like, going Meta Knight?
Yes.
Do you want, like, just explain what happened, because it's kind of maybe a spoiler? I don't know.
Basically, he's talking about going through and, like, making everybody happy and doing them all favors and then getting curious. He's like, what would happen if I did this? And he's like, then I started killing them. At first, I was like, I don't like this. But then it started to feel so liberating. And he's like, at least we're better than the people who watch it happen. It's like, oh, God.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like,
I'm not a good thing. I'm not watching it. I'm a good person still. That card was taken away from me a long time ago.
I think that's... his exact words are like, at least we're better than the people that, like, that can't do it themselves. The people that just watch it happen. I bet there's some people watching right now.
Yeah, exactly. That's what he says.
It's like, oh fuck.
There's some people watching.
That's
ooh,
not...
and they're trying.
Ooh.
How did he know about my plans to finish the race? I mean, when did he know I was going to finish my Bible studies?
He wants to finish the race.
You're right, you better run, because I'm going to run faster.
Dude, you can't outrun black people. Like, literally all Africans that are still alive got away from the slave traders, so...
That's because they were super white. I can run.
Super white.
Super white.
Back then you had two types of white. It was olive-colored skin if you were from Sicily, because you were half black anyway. And,
wow.
Like, Wonder Bread.
Wonder Bread.
On the bread now, officially a skin tone.
I'm like 12% Native American. I got some color to my skin at least. I'm not like fucking pasty white Magoo over there, fucking Sully up there living up in Canada and shit.
Wow.
Getting a snow color. Better learn, I'm not racist because I'm racist towards everybody.
Okay.
Except for myself.
Are you sure that doesn't just make you really, really racist?
No, I'm using South Park Live.
Look, if I kill so many people, if I kill everyone, then actually I didn't kill anyone because nobody's there to say I killed anyone.
Exactly.
See, that's why we're doing a genocide run. See, you gotta all go all in. Oh my god.
You see, following South Park logic at this point. If I'm racist to everybody, I'm no longer racist.
Do it for me.
Do it for the Vine!
Do it. So honestly,
do it for all the hits I get on Vine, everybody.
Honestly, there's like two legitimate fights in a genocide run. That's what I'm getting here.
Alright.
Because you have... There's an actual challenge in fighting Undyne in her fancy form. Metaton just fucking dies. Everybody else just fucking dies.
Then who's left?
Sans.
Because hey,
he got to judge our ass.
I'm in the mood for a bit of an emo off at the moment.
Nah.
Might you? Fuck off.
You haven't earned an emo off.
Whoa.
Why not?
Flowey is not feeling too good.
I bet he's cutting himself right now. That's what I do when I want to have fun.
I am about to have bad time. I'm ready.
Hashtag bad time.
Hashtag bad time.
Oh, Sosuke, you'll never be understood for being a sex symbol in this show.
Hey, Palmer John.
Hello.
Nobody else can... Oh. Parmesan? Did I hear?
Parmesan.
Oh, Parmesan.
Oh, Parmesan. I know this person. This is a person I know. Hey.
How are you, sir?
We're about to have a bad time. If you don't want spoilers for this game, it's really good. You might want to...
Yeah. I want to stop playing Undertale. just stop. Turn off the video game. Ryan, turn off the game console right now.
Shut up! Spoilers, God!
This game is
but
amazing.
Ryan should totally turn off the game console and kill himself until he gets amazing in MGS4. Like, holy shit!
Holy shit!
Like, doing the big boss run.
Quade, do you know the game Party Hard?
No. I know the game Bad Time.
That's what you're gonna have right now, motherfucker!
Hey, Sai, next week I might do Dragon Guard if you could help me get PSX emulator.
Oh, I will.
Thank
you.
Well,
that I will.
It's a beautiful day outside.
I'd totally be down for that.
Birds are singing. Flowers are blooming. On days like
these,
kids like you
should be burning in hell.
Quaddy.
Fuck! Oh my gosh! It's all good.
You know, I thought of a Silent Hill game that would be pretty good to riff on, even though it's still a good game in general.
I feel like I'm gonna have a bad time.
Silent Hill 1.
Silent Hill 1 is a great game.
It is pretty good.
But it's pretty dated, so I could see where you could riff on it.
I don't think it's dated, I think it's scary as fuck.
I'm not denying that. I'm just saying, like, the
scary
the voice
and how raw the
like,
graphics are. Yeah.
The true horror is Harry's spindly chin.
Oh my god.
Dude, to me, one of the only moments in video games that could still make me cry is the moment when the nurse lady there, she just kind of like comes at you and she's like bleeding down the face.
Yeah,
it was fucked up.
And I'm like, the moment's never really explained. It's just kind of like, is she turning into a monster? Or did you push her up against the wall so hard that she just kind of like got a brain tumor? And it exploded at the same time it formed.
Oh,
shit. Oh, is he fighting Sans right now?
Yeah. Unfortunately, massive anomaly in time-space continuum. Timelines jumping left and right, stopping and starting. Science, bitch.
Science, motherfucker.
You don't know, like, the image I have in my head is definitely better than what's going on screen right now, but I'm just imagining the main character with that, like, dagger going against Sans with another dagger as they're, like, floating through time and space and just doing, like, some Metal Gear Revengeance bullshit.
It's Sansical. It's Sansical. He's gonna play some Timeline Correction Simulator 21X.
And kill you before you do anything?
Yes.
Well, it's, well, I mean, like,
no Parmesan. Or whoever was saying goodnight. It was Macklemore was saying goodnight.
Yeah, I'm dead this time.
Goodnight, Macklemore. I need a new,
night.
Single from you soon.
Oh, never mind, Macklemore's not sleeping. Who the fuck's sleeping then?
Yo, who's even sleeping?
We will never know.
Who left? We'll look at it that way. Or is nobody sleeping? Are we just saying night-night for no fucking reason?
Yeah. Fuck. Well, I had a bad time.
Morons.
Morons. Ignoramuses.
You fucking... You fucking ignoramuses.
Ignoramus.
You Rick Moranises.
You potatoes.
There is no Christina, only Zool.
Only Zool.
That was my favorite. That was one of my more favorite recent Brad Jones jokes when he was doing a review of Exorcist 2. And he's like, there is no Reagan, only Zool.
I'm bad at that part. Why not relax? Take a load off. Dead. Alright, I have to use the bathroom. I'll be right back.
Enjoy yourself.
Why would he enjoy himself in the pisser? Or the shitter, depending on what he's doing.
Don't you think that pissing is relieving and enjoyable?
No. It's annoying. It gets in the way of me doing things.
Ural, we can't start sparing people now.
What we need to do... Macklemore, I can kink shame whoever I want here. I do... Speaking of kink shaming, Weeaboo Jones.
Alright. So,
I'm just kidding, he's a good guy.
So yeah, there actually is a fan animation for Undertale that has Critical voicing Sans, and ever since I saw that, I can't think
Oh my god.
I can't think of Sans with any other voice, because it's very fitting.
Hey, what's up everybody, I'm Sans, and today we're playing bullshit.
That's exactly what they have him do at the end of the video, it's really perfect.
Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Sans. Today we're gonna be punching the shit out of this fucking ignorant bitch child, piece of shit bitch, donkey ass bitch, motherfucker.
Yep. In other words, he's gonna have a bad time.
Have a bad time, as usual. Like, I'm gonna give your mom a bad time, too.
Hey. Hey, what's up, everybody?
Flying
this is
dick
and
nipples.
Today I'm gonna... Yeah, and today I'm gonna be selling an item for that bitch Anthony Sullivan, cause he can't be here. What a little bitch, he can't sell shit as good as I can.
There's bones everywhere, you know why? Cause this bitch is gonna get boned.
I don't know, I kinda still find him funny. He's a pretty cool dude.
I enjoy him. Like, I don't watch all of his videos, but on occasion when I do watch him, I generally enjoy him.
My favorite one is when he was playing Five Nights at Freddy's 1 and he was so bored he was just telling a random blowjob story.
Yes.
That literally made me laugh my ass off. He's like, oh man, I'm getting so bored, I was waiting for some shit to happen here, so I'm just gonna tell you guys about the one time I pissed in a girl's mouth while she was blowing me.
Oh my god.
It was more or less intense.
Oh my god!
He goes, yeah, so I was at this girl's house, we were just kind of hanging out, chilling on the couch, and, we were getting into it, so, she decided to go down on me, but I really had to take a leak.
That's critical.
And so I decided, well, what better time than the present, right? So I just kind of pissed her mouth, and then she got really angry, and then she didn't finish me off, so I had to go into her bathroom and kind of finish myself.
Ha! What a bit?
And then he's just sitting there, and he's like, oh god, I really wish that something would happen in this fucking game. Then all of a sudden he gets jump scared by Foxy. He's like, oh, it looks like it was the titty patrol back again.
Shit.
Like, he wasn't even afraid, like, he didn't even get a shock. He was like, oh shit, looks like the titty patrol came back.
Yeah. Okay, I think I need one of these.
Or when he was playing the fourth one, he's like,
shit. That was a mistake. Oh, making all the mistakes, Jesus.
I was going directly
where all the lasers were.
If he stops squeaking, my cheeks stop peeking, or something really retarded like that.
I just saw on the stream the giant skulls come in during, like, a different attack. I was like, oh my god, they're in here too now. It freaked me out.
Harry Potter's coming back? What the fuck?
Really? Why?
What?
And wait, now he's a dad.
Isn't that like,
they're rewriting
right
a story
now?
of like Harry Potter's like kids now.
Oh, come on.
No! No!
No!
Well, at least he's like
money.
He's gonna be in the books, but he's gonna be like giving them like a wizard dad.
He's gonna be giving.
So it's like, this is how you expect a patronum. This is how you get into Hermione's pants real good.
Oh yeah, this is how you get into Hermione's pants real good.
I would like to go into Hermione's pants real good.
It's like the, I forgot who made this animation. It might have been Onwaji or whatever the hell, however the hell you say his fucking name. Onwaji? Yeah, alright. Yeah, it's Onwaji. So, yeah, the one that was, where they take the body-changing spell, like, where they, like, do, like, some, like, potion or, like, spell that gives them vaginas, and you just hear Ron and Harry in the bathroom just like...
Harry Potter.
My favorite video from him was Left for Speed 2.
Yeah.
Hey, Alice, look! Oh, Kitty Land! Hey, Alice, look, it's Kitty Land. Do I look like some sort of queer to you? Hey, that must be that guy who masturbates all day! Hey, we got that soda you wanted. Oh, wait, I'm masturbating! Okay, I'll just leave it outside.
Whoa. Ah!
My friends call me Coach! Oh, that's cool. Football!
I don't think I have any healing items left.
I got the hair. I mean adrenaline.
I don't have any more healing items. Fuck.
I think in order to beat Sans, you have to like get through a certain amount of dialogue. I think. I'm not sure.
I just got to like the. Like, he has at least a few more attacks after this. He starts fucking with the whole stage ground and all that. So yeah, I need to do better than I did this time.
I'm trying to think of what's another one of his... his video, The Dark Knight.
You know what? Yeah, everybody in chat wants me to spare him. And I'm gonna do that because I'm gonna die otherwise, so we'll at least be able to show this off.
Yeah. This is cute.
This is very cute. You're sparing me? Finally. Buddy, pal, I know how hard it must be to make that choice, to go back on everything you've worked up to. I want you to know, I won't let it go to waste. Come here, pal. Dead.
Dead. Really? He just, like, backstabs you and just kills you completely.
Get dunked on!
What he does is, if you agree to spare to him, he locks your, like little space where you move around your heart full of projectiles.
Yep. He basically just puts you in a prison of bones that constantly do damage until you die. It's beautiful.
Oh, wow.
That's what happened to my mom.
Yep.
Wow.
Wow.
A prison of bones!
Bones? Did you say bones? Sans is chugging.
Also, it appears Zony hasn't made a video in a while.
He's probably just been making porn.
Yeah, probably.
If an animator hasn't been putting anything out lately, it's because they've been.
I forgot he was the one who did Leo and Satan.
Didn't Satan? The old
look, the Yoshi Ouija boy. Darn you, Kaka Carrot Cake, you have no real Super Sand!
I'll show you real Super Sand, lesbians.
That was, what do you mean, Virginia?
Virginia?
Defeating a sandwich only makes it defeating a sandwich only makes it tastier. Don't ever let me see you back on my earth, you big fat willy.
You big fat willy.
But I still like his video to Dark Knight there. He's like, the Joker comes in and he's got the guy with the pencil, the one that he stabs in the eye. He's like, hey, let's play Pictionary. Just kidding. Do you know how I got these scars? My father was an asshole. It was an alcoholic. And a fag. I swear, if you get pepperoni, I'll blow this place sky high. But you know I love my meat. Yep, man, you a faggot.
I guess. Do I get anything out of doing the mystery key thing, or is it the same as a normal playthrough? I'm guessing it's
same thing.
Got it. Okay. How much money do I have left? Oh wow, I have.
I see a hostile. I forgot my socks.
Alright, so I have two full heals.
I want to make out with you.
Heroes,
I would like that.
And a face stake. I don't think face stake's better than a legendary hero, though. Eh. But. I have a lot of legendary heroes now. This should work, I hope.
The scene there at the beginning where they're doing the bank heist, the guy comes down with a shotgun and he's like, do you know who I'm sleeping with right now? My own mother!
So you've all seen Kung Pao, I hope, right?
Yeah, hell yeah.
Of course.
Okay, good. You know the scene where I implore you to reconsider? Do you know what he's actually saying?
What?
What?
No. He's saying, I'm someone's mummy!
Okay. You know that scene where he says, that's a lot of nuts! He's actually saying, that's a lot of nuts!
I need gopher chucks!
Thanks, baby! Want fries with that?
Unless I am passed out from pain, or if I tell you, don't stop hitting me. Ah! Oh god! He stopped saying it. But he didn't tell us to stop. I mean...
My face to your fist style, how do you like it?
My face to your fist style, how do you like it? You know, you might be a great warrior on some other planet, but your one weakness is, you're on Earth. How's about your foot to my nut style? No, don't beat up! We trained him horrible on purpose as a joke. I am bleeding, making me the victor.
Making me the victor.
Oh god. Again with the speech.
From now on, you will call me Betty.
Betty.
But Betty is a woman's name. Oh, calm down. We don't want anyone losing any more toes. Ow, that's still raw.
Quite
to prove I'm
price.
Not a horrible guy. Let me start out with a joke. What do you get when you cross an owl with a bungee cord? My ass.
Okay. Is that an actual joke, or is he just like a, is that a shitty thing?
No, it's just a shitty thing.
Okay, good.
This is the one line of, I'll lose it. Oh, Jesus Christ, what even is that thing? I call him Tonguey.
Tonguey.
Ay, 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 ay! Hey, you! I'm here to kick your ass!
Oh my god, did you see that? He, like, punched a hole right through his stomach. I mean, Jesus, I mean, I'm no doctor, but, like, that doesn't even seem possible. Like, there's, like, organs and... Oh god.
Damn it, 10 people survived.
Son of a bitch.
It's just like the real Holocaust.
You mean the Holocaust?
The Holocaust?
So something I love is that Toby Fox has had the same theme going since he did like Earthbound ROM packs. There's like a history to this song. It's like kind of his thing that he puts in everything that he works on or with.
It's cute. It's always like a song that plays whenever a good person is going up against some kind of stupidly overpowered, unstoppable evil.
Yeah.
So,
like John Cena?
Well, in that case, it's kind of the reverse.
Actually,
because we're kind of the super evil piece of shit.
Well, the thing is that there's a song on the soundtrack called "The Song That Might Play When You Fight Sans," and
yeah.
As you can imagine, it doesn't play when you fight Sans. Megalovania does, but people are saying that. Your evil malice overrides his theme music.
Oh. Oh, you know what that reminds me of? Super Robot Wars actually has a character who had a glitch where even if he was fighting like a super crazy boss, his theme overrode their theme. So he got really popular purely based on the fact that his theme overrode everything. Which is really
That's
hilarious.
Pretty
nice. Yeah. I forget what his name is. If anybody knows what I'm talking about, it's Super Robot Wars. It's Trombe. If you look up Trombe, that theme just overrides anything. Like, you could be fighting the final boss of, like, Evangelion arc or something like that, and instead of, like, Evangelion music, it just plays Trombe. Which is kind of fucking amazing.
That's awesome.
Shit! Oh my god! Some of these things just go way too fast. Whew. Okay. Eating all these heroes. I'm having a bad time. So Sans is doing his—he's doing his job very well.
Well, it's like he knows he can't win, so he's just trying to give you the most frustrating time he possibly can to make you quit.
I know, and I love that.
It's such a good fight.
Like, he's probably the most entertaining, omnipotent character that I've seen in a long time. He's like Q from Star Trek or something.
Yeah. Where he's
I can
just
see
like
it.
Yeah, he's just interesting. Everything about him is interesting, mainly because you don't know a lot about him.
Alright, here we go. I got to the mercy part and I haven't used, like, all of my healing items yet, so. Friendship, yo. Let's do all the friendship. Well, let me legendary hero myself up, because I'm gonna need that. Okay. Let's do this. Whoa, you look really pissed off. Did I get you?
Yeah.
Oh my god! I didn't know that happened.
Oh, so you think you're the chosen one? I dare you to hop over that wall!
Don't tell that to the other Sanses, okay? Oh my god. Alright, now...
Meta!
No, he's breaking the whole world!
He's
just skipping...
the fourth walls!
He's just...
Someone stop him!
All of the fourth walls, everywhere.
So now he's skipping different battle phases. He actually has bones going across all of the different symbols. Well, not yet, but he's going to. It's gonna get fucking crazy, in essence. Real battle finally begins.
Just everything about his character is so interesting. Like, his motives.
Some nice friends. Like,
what? He's so fucking cool.
His name.
I'm the unstoppable evil Jesus. I can't be the unstoppable evil.
Instant noodles sounds good. Ah!
I guess Quaddy had to bring me in to balance out the universe.
You have to balance out the universe, man. What would we do without you balancing out the universe?
Psy would have taken over this chat long ago.
Well, Psy would have liked that.
But I won't let him, because I'm like the yin to his yang. You kill either of us. Anarchy
ensues.
Leave
my wang alone. Good.
I said yang, not wang.
You should have said wang. It would have been better. I mean, obviously.
I'm the wing to your wang.
I'm the wing to your chum.
Who wants a taste of wang? That's one of my favorite lines from
Overcome.
Don't you
know that you're my hero?
Who wants a taste of the wang? He says that in Shadow Warrior 2013, too.
Yeah, but in the original one, like, you're an older guy, he's like, who wants a taste of Wang?
I do.
I want the Wang.
And for lunch, I have the Wiener. Schnitzel,
ooh yeah.
Got to have surf with my turf, and wash it down with some butter.
I got caught on a bone, and I just kinda stuck there till it exploded. As you do. Shit. Well, I think it's just a matter of execution now. I have all the healing items I can take.
I've killed nearly everyone at this fucking party now.
All my health.
Because here's what would happen if you were to get rid of me or Psy. The negative energy from one side or the other would become so powerful to the point where everybody would just get crippling depression within an hour.
Yeah, you're like the harassment soldiers in Metal Gear Solid 5.
But me and Psy's depressions both even each other out. So
they're like the harassment Mother Base combat soldiers in
Metal Gear. Oh, yeah!
If you put two of them together, they're fine, but if there's just one of them, then they just explode everyone.
I didn't even give a fuck about my mother base management, honestly.
No, yeah, I kind of just completely let it by the wayside by this
point. I just found that, like, most people just, like, see a knocked out, like, just knock somebody out and just be like, and back to base again.
Well, it's like, part of the thing is, like, okay, this might sound kind of Hitler-y, but I didn't care.
No episode starts like this can end good.
Can end well. But I didn't notice. I forget if I didn't notice or I didn't care about the infection that happens like midway through the game.
Oh, yeah.
So, like,
I was too busy doing missions and so many people died. But my favorite soldier didn't die, so I was okay. Cunning Mastiff still lives on.
Cunning Mastiff, the worst soldier in Mother Base.
He's so fucking good. He's always about to cry.
Crawling in his skin.
He's not even edgy. He's just really
when
sad.
They cry.
Oh, so just how could this happen to me?
Yeah, sure. That's Cunning Mastiff. He's just always really, really despondent.
Cunning Mastiff.
It's just like
Cunning Masturbator.
Is he a cunning linguist?
Yes.
Hey,
he isn't actually a linguist because he can't speak.
I mean, you know, why not both?
Triggered.
he can do sign language if he wanted to.
That is actually one of the stupidest things about Quiet's character.
Yeah. She couldn't have just written shit down on a piece of paper. Nah, we don't have any fucking pencils on Mother Base, sorry.
Yeah, no, it's sorry, we only write in pen, and she can't stand ink getting on her hands, I mean.
I think it's like...
She breathes through her skin!
Well, it's like there's a whole plot point brought up later in the game about how the fact that like Quiet needs to tell Boss something, but she can't speak. Apparently, Kojima forgot that people can write.
Well, it was the helicopter guy. Like, it was over walkie-talkies, and the guy didn't understand her language. So in that case, like, sure.
Yeah.
But for a lot of other plot points prior to that point, she could have been a lot better with warning people.
Oh, the only thing that I honestly want that game for is just the Phantom Cigar. So that way I could just sit there and be like, smoke weed every day. Wake up like 20 minutes later and just be like, wait, why is it night out right now?
Whoa.
Shit. Oh, man. Dude,
you just wake up surrounded by tranked soldiers. It's like, what did I do?
Just like, it's like,
and why is my penis tattooed?
Yeah, man, it's like you wake up and you're like,
why is there a suppressor on my penis?
and where did my Doritos go? Oh god, my Doritos!
They're just
my Doritos.
Cheeto, like, Dorito dust is just spread all over his face.
As we all know, Boss invented both Doritos and Axe Body Spray.
Fuck! Oh my god.
And the 8-bit sunglasses.
I keep accidentally running into something, and then instead of getting off of it, I just follow it for a while. And it just drains out the rest of my health.
I wonder if somebody has, like, modded the game on the PC version for whenever you light the Phantom Cigar, instead of the song it normally plays, it just plays part of In a God of Vita.
I mean, yeah.
7 times in a row. 7's a lucky number, maybe I'll hit the jackpot.
It's gotta play the God of Vita in its entirety, all 21 minutes, 7 times in a row to everyone.
In a God of Vita, baby.
Here we go.
That's a song I think I listened to in its entirety once before I just kinda gave up.
What, Living La Vida Loca?
No, God of Vita.
Just, nah. You know what?
That's the whole lyrics of the song, and then bam, bam, da, 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 da. And you're like, does this song end? And somebody's like, no. Some say it still goes on.
I saw that song done live, and it's longer. It's 45 minutes.
Combo, you can't spam skip his dialogue at the start. Like, it's not possible. I've been mashing X for the past 2 attempts.
Iron Butterfly. Was at a rock show and did this song live. It was 45 fucking minutes. I almost gave up on life.
I just it wasn't worth it to live anymore.
Yeah, seriously, listening to the just the entire riff for 45 minutes. That burn, 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 burn. That entire thing, 45 minutes straight. And then sometimes a guy would come in just, and I got it to read. And I'm like, Jesus fucking Christ, kill me. I looked at my girlfriend, I looked her straight in the eye. I was like, if you have a knife, stab me.
If you have a God of Vita, please. Use it on me, kill me.
Don't
with
put
it.
Me in it.
What is a God of Vita?
Do not put me in the God of Vita.
Whatever the God of Vita is. Use it and end me.
You know the reason why this song's called that, right?
Why? Because it's a God of
Eden. Okay, so it was originally supposed to be called In a Garden of...
Oh, In the Garden of Eden, but yeah. But he couldn't pronounce it.
But the guy was,
like,
completely sloshed. He was sitting in the corner. I forget if he was either drunk or if he was, like, on, like, heroin or something. They couldn't pronounce it, so he's like, hey, In a Garden of Eden. So, like, holy shit, that sounds amazing.
So that's actually, like, a true story? I thought that was a joke, because Tom told me that. I was like, that can't be a thing.
What
but
the
fuck
is it? That is actually the true story.
That's kind of amazing.
Yeah, he was like, I forgot if he was either drunk or on heroin, but he was sitting in the corner of the room and the guy's like, so what's that song you've been
writing? Why not both,
like,
yeah.
In a God of Vita.
Yeah. Why do you have so drunk?
Wait, oh! God damn it, I used the instant noodles without meaning to.
Don't you know that what's this guy's... This guy's voice literally sounds like he's on, like, all the steroids.
Or having, like, the worst fucking constipation of his
trip
life.
Ever.
And that.
Constipation trip. Dude, he sounds like he's
constipation trip. He stuck too many drugs up his butt. He used too many drug suppositories.
Jim, they weren't suppositories. What the hell are you doing?
I was in the Garden of Evil, the baby.
Don't you know that I love you?
Look, Jim, I know you feel that way about me, but it's just not gonna work out.
But the Garden of Vita.
The Garden of Vita.
We need to give this like an Arnold vibe. Get to the Vita! Get to the chopper!
Get to the Gata de Vita!
I think I might be the only one here who actually knows the lyrics to that song because of hearing it for 45 fucking minutes.
To be fair, I also don't
45 Gata de Vitas.
45? No, it's technically two whole Gata de Vitas, but
it's
like...
two whole Gata de Vitas, guys.
But here's the thing.
The whole goddamn
One Gata de Vita is enough to kill a small country. Two! That leaves you mentally scarred for life.
You become a Gata de Vita at that point. Yeah.
Why do you think I want to torture you people with singing? Because after dealing with that song for 45 minutes, I have to pass along. It's like smile.jpg. I have to pass it along or else it haunts me in my nightmares.
Oh my god.
I still don't get the... I mean, there's some creepy stories that are mildly scary, but like... Smile.jpg was always more like.
Why do you think it was called smile.jpg and not like scared.jpg?
Have I shown you smile?
Because smiling is creepy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Stop it, Ron.
I will now post my favorite piece of brony culture in chat.
Oh god.
Baby! Don't you know that I love? Gata de Vita! I know why he's constipated! Because of that heroin he went on as he was trying to pronounce the name of the song.
Alright, tell me when Quaddy, you stopped and I will start as well.
Because, Quaddy, you know how, like, opioids cause constipation?
I don't know that, actually.
Yeah. I posted the song in stream chat, and I would highly appreciate if we watched it together.
As you know, heroin's an opioid, that's why he sounds constipated in the song.
Hey, whoa!
That's why he sounds constipated in the song, after the heroin he took when he couldn't pronounce the name of it.
I see.
He's just straight up just like, I shouldn't have done that, I shouldn't have shot up, and I got out of me!
Tell me when you're at 0-0.
Going
then.
Might take a little bit,
it's
super tense right now.
Fuck! Oh my god! Sins! I'm dead. Yeah, again? Oh my god, he pushes you back down into it.
Although you're quite amazing at this bullet telly thingamabob.
Yeah, it's really hard though. I understand why it's having a bad time. No, I understand. I gotta really preserve those healing items for the last few turns.
This one person in the comment section for this song puts, "Wow, I'll never get tired of this." They haven't listened to it for 45 minutes straight.
As is intended.
Yeah, like just to think, their envision for playing that song live was, hey, this song would sound great for like double the time.
I'm not gonna watch this, because this is gonna turn super evil. Yeah, it is. Okay.
Ready?
Hold on. Is it gonna be like super edgy? Or
nah,
scary?
It will be
so
fine.
Much edge.
Okay. Three.
The edge
two,
of the edge.
One, go.
Yeah, literally. There's like. There's an entire 4 minutes of singing in the song, and the rest of it's all like keyboard and guitar.
Yep.
Uh-oh.
It's an animation by Dave Davey.
I don't know who Dave Davey is.
Yo, Dave Davey! Shit, Dave Davey.
Do you remember your President Nixon, the young Americans?
Do you remember?
When it first started in September.
How do you like it so far?
I can tell this is gonna turn into murder in like 2 seconds.
2 second murder.
There it is.
This song to me is almost as annoying as listening to the song White Room by Cream. I don't know. Because I don't think Eric Clapton's all that great of a guitarist, to be honest.
I was at Rarity's dead body.
Yeah.
In a white room with curtains in the dungeon.
You know what? Eating those instant noodles when I didn't need them was probably what killed me last time. Among other things, but I would have been closer at least if I had those noodles.
You see, you would have been closer to winning if you had listened to Agata DeVita for 45 minutes.
Here.
I'd become Agata DeVita yourself.
I don't know, I think I'd be right where I am now if I had listened to Agata DeVita for that long.
You probably would have been worse off, to be honest, because you wouldn't be playing the game. You'd just be banging your head up against the wall. You just like,
to the
stop,
rhythm of the music.
Stop.
Bong, 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 bong,
bong. Won't you come with me and take my hand? You start breaking down halfway through.